We have just finished the second section. In this part, we introduced a very classic TD algorithm that can estimate the state value of a given policy. We analyzed many of its properties, such as why it is designed this way, what mathematical problem it solves, and its convergence properties. We also compared the TD algorithm with the Monte Carlo method we previously studied. Although the second part is just one of the 8 sections, the insights it provides into the properties and ideas of the TD method are extremely important. I hope everyone has understood well. Next, we will build upon this foundation to introduce 4 more algorithms: Sarsa, Expected Sarsa, and N-Step Sarsa. From their names, you can see that they belong to the same family, being variations of the basic Sarsa algorithm. Finally, we will introduce the Q-learning algorithm. What do Sarsa and its variations do? Given a policy, they can estimate the action value, thus performing policy evaluation. By combining this with policy improvement, we can find optimal policies. Q-learning, on the other hand, directly solves for the optimal action value, thereby finding the optimal policy directly. Before we start, I need to mention that readers are suggested to carefully study Sarsa, and then selectively study expected Sarsa or N-step Sarsa based on your interest. Now, let's look at the algorithm of Sarsa. In the previous section, we introduced a TD algorithm that estimates the state value of a given policy. When improving a policy, we need to estimate the action value because we choose the action with the highest value as the new policy. The previous TD algorithm cannot estimate action values. The algorithm we are about to introduce, called Sarsa, can directly estimate action values. You will see that Sarsa and the TD algorithm we just introduced are very similar. After estimating the action value with Sarsa, we have essentially performed policy evaluation. This alone cannot generate the optimal policy. The goal of reinforcement learning is to find the optimal policy. How do we do this? By combining the Sarsa policy evaluation algorithm with the policy improvement algorithm, we can find the optimal policy. Next, I will introduce 2 parts. First, given a policy, how do we estimate its action value? Without a model, we need experience data. Suppose we have this experience, which is a set of data points at different time steps t. Each data point consists of st, at, rt plus 1, st plus 1, and at plus 1. With this experience, how do we proceed? We use this algorithm to update the estimates. Here, QSA is an estimate of Q pi SA. If it is QT, it is the estimate at time t. Let's look at the first equation. QT plus 1 equals QT minus alpha QT minus RT plus 1 plus gamma QT. This is identical to the TD algorithm we introduced earlier, except that instead of VST, we now have QST AT. So previously, for each state S, we estimated V pi S. Now for each SA, we estimate Q pi SA. By making this simple substitution, we obtain this new algorithm. This is the first equation. The second equation is simple. If I am in state ST and take action at the current time step, I can update its Q value. If the current state is not the one being visited, then the Q value remains unchanged. This algorithm is called Sarsa. Why is it called Sarsa? It stands for State Action Reward State Action, representing the sequence of data used, ST, AT, RT plus 1, ST plus 1, and AT plus 1. These correspond to the letters S, A, R, S, and A, forming Sarsa. What is the relationship between Sarsa and the TD algorithm we introduced earlier? As you can see, they are essentially the same. The difference is that instead of estimating the state value, we are estimating the action value. What mathematical problem does Sarsa solve? Like the TD algorithm, Sarsa solves a Bellman equation. However, the form of the Bellman equation is different. It looks like this. On the left side is Q pi as A, and on the right side is ER plus gamma Q pi S prime A prime. Unlike the previous Bellman equations we have seen, this one is based on action values instead of state values. This Bellman equation describes the relationship between different action values, but fundamentally, it is still a Bellman equation. For detailed analysis, you can refer to my book. The convergence of this algorithm is similar to the TD algorithm. The theorem states that QTSA will converge to QPi as A when certain conditions are met. These conditions are mainly about the learning rate alpha t. This theorem says the action value can be estimated by SARSA for a given policy pi. To find optimal policies, we need to combine this process with policy improvement. This combination of SARSA and the policy improvement step is also often called SARSA. When people refer to SARSA, they usually mean the combined algorithm. Here is the pseudocode of this algorithm. Let's go through it briefly. For each episode, what do we do? If the current state is not the target state, we proceed with the following steps. At time t, we get an experience. In state st, we take action at according to the current policy, receive reward rt plus 1, and transition to the next state st plus 1. In the next state, we sample an action at plus 1 based on the policy at that state. This gives us the experience needed for SARSA. Next, we need to perform the Q value update, also known as policy evaluation. We calculate the Q value corresponding to pi t. This is given by the equation we previously discussed. After this, we perform a policy update. How do we update the policy? We select the action with the highest Q value. However, this is done using an epsilon greedy policy. It means that instead of always choosing the greedy action with a probability of 1, we choose it with a high probability, while still giving a small probability to other actions. After obtaining this policy, we use it to generate new experiences and continue the iteration process. One point to note about this algorithm is that it consists of two steps. The first step is the Q value update, or policy evaluation. The second step is policy improvement. After updating the Q value, we immediately update the policy. This is slightly different from the traditional policy evaluation process, where we gather a lot of data to accurately estimate the action value for the current policy pi t. In this algorithm, we perform the policy update immediately after policy evaluation, without having obtained an accurate action value. This approach is based on the idea of generalized policy iteration. Recall the policy iteration method we studied earlier. It also consists of two steps: policy evaluation and policy improvement. Each iteration includes both steps. Accurately calculating the state value during policy evaluation requires infinite steps, so in practice, we might only take one or a few steps before switching to policy improvement. The SARSA algorithm follows this same idea. Additionally, the updated policy is not a greedy policy, but an epsilon greedy policy. This allows the algorithm to explore more state action pairs, SA, and potentially find better policies. To summarize, SARSA has two main parts. The first part is to derive the SARSA algorithm to solve the Bellman equation for a given policy. The second part is to combine policy evaluation with policy improvement to find optimal policies. The most complex part of this, the iterative equation, is for policy evaluation, specifically to calculate the action value. This is its core idea. Once you grasp this concept, the rest becomes easier. The algorithm might seem a bit complex because it involves iteration, policy improvement, and maintaining an epsilon greedy policy. Overall, I hope you can grasp its core ideas and understand what each part is doing. Let's illustrate SARSA with an example. In this example, we consider a task where we start from a specific state and need to find a good path to the target state. Note that this task is different from the grid world tasks we have seen previously. Previously, the grid world tasks aimed to find the optimal policy for every state. However, here we only focus on finding a path from a specific state to the target state. This scenario is quite common in real world applications. In this example, the specific starting state is the top left one. I hope you can distinguish the tasks between finding a good path to the target and finding the optimal policy for every state. This is the optimal policy found by SARSA, starting from an initial policy. The initial state is the top left corner. If we follow the direction with the highest probability, we can reach the target, indicating that we have achieved our objective. However, as I mentioned earlier, many other states do not have an optimal policy yet. Is it possible that the found path is not the shortest or optimal? Could the optimal path be in unexplored areas? This is possible. It depends on whether you want to find the optimal policy for all states or just a feasible path from a state to the target. If you want to find the optimal policy for all states, you must explore all state action pairs. In this task, we only have 500 episodes. Let's look at this figure to understand better. This is the first time we introduce this type of figure in the course, so I will explain it in detail. The horizontal axis represents the episode index. Here we have 500 episodes starting from the left. As we continuously improve the policy and collect new episodes, we move along the horizontal axis. The vertical axis on the first subfigure represents the total reward obtained in each episode. In the beginning, the total reward is negative. Why? Because the initial policy is not good, causing the agent to hit walls or enter forbidden areas, leading to many negative rewards. As the policy improves, the total reward increases, but does not exceed zero. Even when reaching the target, it remains slightly negative due to the epsilon greedy policy, which occasionally results in negative rewards. The second subfigure represents the episode length. Initially, the episode length is quite long, indicating that the initial policy is poor and the agent takes many steps before reaching the target. As the policy improves, the episode length decreases. Initially, it took several hundred steps to reach the target, but with the improved policy, it now takes only a few dozen steps.